What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video on my journey building a Hevort 3D printer and modding the E3D tool changer hardware and tools onto it. So this was my senior project. For those who don't know, I had it sponsored by my work, part of the university, and I've put a little bit of my own money into this. Quite an expensive printer, but quite some functionality it has, or it will have. So on to kind of some updates. The mosquito liquid that you see in front of you right here, this hot end, I made this 3D printed piece with some brass inserts, and I've just updated this and put it on my Thingiverse page. It has all the components that I used in it, so you're welcome to download that and use it for, I believe it'll probably be able to be used on any air-cooled one as well, but I know there is existing ones out there that other people, you know, you can use as well. So this one I found works really well for the mosquito liquid so far. So it's printed out of nylon carbon fiber, which I need for the heat resistance, as the hot end will be in an enclosure, a heated enclosure, so we need that temperature resistance, and the nylon provides that. So kind of an explanation as to why I haven't been uploading the last 6 months mainly comes down to my senior project, just taking so much time, senior year, work, you know, all the things. Got a new puppy. And so I also had to study for my FE exam, which, if you're not familiar, is like kind of like an ACT or a SAT for your 4 years as an engineer studying in college. It goes over everything. So I passed that. So happy about that. It's a 5.5 hour session of 110 questions. So it was pretty grueling, but got through it, and thankful for that. But now I'm excited to be able to work on this more and to share more with you guys, get it running. I have made progress with the printer in the fact that it probes the bed and it levels, so that's great. Moves fine. There's a little bit of friction in the belt system, and I'm working on remedying that right now with some pulley stuff, but I'll show you that in the next video. All the heaters work, all the high voltage, or the high wattage stuff rather, the bed heater that's 1200 watts, that thing heats up quick, 1000 watt enclosure heater, all the hot ends work. I will be converting it over to 220, kind of. I'll explain that later when I'm downstairs, but excited for, you know, all of the views I've gotten, all the interest as well. It's pretty exciting for me, and grateful for all of you tuning in and enjoying what I have as well. We'll go downstairs and check out what I've done. All right, guys, so here's the printer as it is right now. It's pretty messy right now, but I've unhooked a few things, but here's a quick little panorama around it. So the tool changer I've torn apart because the end posts here that are shoulder screws, I'm gonna swap those out for some shorter ones and make that a better design. There's gonna be a piece of like a wood panel here that all this cabling's gonna attach to. Right now it's really, really messy. But for the power right here, this is a recent development that I'm going to change over to. So I split this up with the bed and the enclosure heater, and then the DC power supply right there. And you can see the solid state relays. I'm going to switch that to a 220 plug. And I'm going to do one leg of 110 to basically the plugs you see. That's how it's going to run. One leg of 110 for the enclosure and bed heater, and then the other leg is going to go to the DC power supply. So cable management, it's okay. It's not the greatest, but the water pump works. The hot ends have been tested. I believe I'll include that clip of the video in. That was a while ago. Tonight I've been working a lot on my printer, and so actually the nozzle just heated up to 400 Celsius. So here's the first look at the mosquito liquid on my tool changer, and you can smell it. It stinks pretty good, but you can see on the temperature here we're at 401, so I think I'm going to try to bump it up maybe a little more to 450. That's what I have the max set at. Yeah, everything's kind of torn apart right now, but the main thing that I wanted to highlight was this again. So as you can see here, the mosquito liquid is sitting there pretty well. It's actually very very vertical. That's a great way to put it, Jordan. It's pretty rigid and fairly constrained in the vertical direction. So it's not like cambered at all, very much. So basically this is just the carbon fiber nylon mount with those screws that go on the tool plate. And then there's threaded, I don't know if you can see them or not, probably not, threaded inserts that are just set in with a soldering iron. Then this PTFE coupler right here, that just, I actually printed the threads in there. It didn't print very well, but it was enough to kind of force turn it in there, and it lines up really well with the opening of the mosquito liquid. So I have tested this thing up to 450 Celsius, and I'll include a screenshot playing on the screen right now of the thermal gun on it and the temperature of the cold zone, which was about, I think, 20 something Celsius. I'll put that on screen, but it's performing really well. I'm really happy with it. So everything's wired up and functional. I've probed it before. The lead screws work great. So everything's coming along, and hopefully I'll be printing before too long, but I just wanted to get this this flag that hits the end stop here and here better and more robust. So that's what I'm working on right now. In the future, I'll obviously be mounting this. This is the enclosure heater that I'm going to use. It's 1,000 watts. I may have to put two of those in. We'll see how fast things heat up. But the fan I'm going to use, I believe I can either use one of these. These are off of an old Stratasys. These blower fans, I think they're 24 volt, and they move quite a bit of air. I do have bigger ones than this, actually. So yeah, check these out. Size comparison. So pretty big. They're both 24 volts, and I believe they pull under the amount of amperage, yeah, 1.1 amps. So I can wire them right into the Duet board without any problems. Just bear with me on this build, guys. It's gonna be kind of slow as of right now. Summer hits, summer's always busy for me. On top of full-time job and just life in general, and I have a new puppy, so yeah. If you know, you know. So hopefully I'll have this thing printing here within a month, and I'll put out another video going over that. So thanks for sticking with me. I know it's been several months since I've uploaded last, but I appreciate you tuning in.